What's up? Hey, this is G4T. I'm here with NAnthony777, another YouTube vlogger out in LA. And I guess because I have 10,000 subs, I can actually go to the YouTube studio facility in Venice Beach. We're going to be going down there talking to some people. Also, Full Screen is a ad network that wants me to join. I'm going to talk to those guys maybe today, this week. And Anthony is going to be coming down here in 2 days. So there's a bunch of crazy stuff going on here locally. One thing I've been noticing is a lot of Department of Homeland Security vehicles, and I gotta catch them. They're actually starting to pull people over. We've caught the Viper teams at the Amtrak stations, you know, checking people's luggage and stuff. And we also, I have some video I'm gonna upload later tonight of this government staging ground where they're taking rainwater containers the size of semi trucks and like 50 or 60 of them, putting them on pieces of property out here. I'm talking to them, and these government contractors are saying it's nothing to worry about, don't worry about it. But to me, it seems to jive well with this whole kind of ramping up in preparation of the military that we've been seeing in Los Angeles region. So what's going on with you, man? How are you surviving right now? We've been talking a lot about survival. The cost of living here is just soaring. Jerry Brown, in all his wisdom, just recently raised the minimum wage to $10 an hour. So now, if you can find a job, you're making 10 bucks an hour if they don't cut your job back because of the higher costs. And I think what we're going to be seeing is that's going to work itself through the economy through inflation. What's your thoughts, man, with the rising costs and prices and all that sort of stuff with your experience right now?
Well, I'm starting to see less stuff in my shopping cart, that's for sure. When I go out and buy food, I'm having to cut back on anything I could cut back on. And the worst thing about it is there's nothing really you could do about it. So my advice to everybody is just to not to get in debt and, you know, not worry about it because there's really nothing you can do about it. So,
yeah, for the last couple of years, I've really evolved with, you know, survival. And I thought, you know, maybe the best thing to do is to get a piece of land, grow some crops. But then, you know, really the government can tax you out the end and they can come down. Whenever you are localized and hunkered down to a location, the government or entities can come in and with their criminal intent take what you have. I really think what we need to have is kind of this kind of mobile activist scavenger type of attitude. That's what I've come over the years, where it's like I'm more of an urban survivor. You know, where can we go? What can we do? How can we minimize the impacts that the government, you know, does against us in our local communities? And, you know, where can we go? Because I know you're thinking about leaving California to go to Texas.
Yeah, go somewhere. I might just leave the country altogether. I'm really putting that I'm thinking about it, honestly, because I shouldn't have to be pain. I mean, that's just ridiculous, man. It's getting to the point that people could say, well, you're getting free this, get free that, the government's providing you with schooling and this and that, but it's getting to the point that the cost of living is outweighing the benefits by a long shot.
Yeah, we're headed to a situation, at least here in California, where we're getting squeezed so badly. I don't think the sheep have woken up, but those of us that have done the research, I think, have pretty much awakened. You know, when you get to a situation where you have two or three families in a household, you know, people aren't able to drive because of the illegal tickets, and people's economic situation is so degraded here, it's almost like, when are the massive amounts of people going to wake up? You know, you know, when are they going to start leaving? I think what people in the Western United States need to prepare for is a massive exodus of Californians.
So we're going to start seeing a massive exodus of the United States, man. Mexico's starting to sound better, man. The last time I went to Mexico, you don't see the people worried about anything. They look younger than we do. You compare to somebody that's their same age, they're a lot younger, they're thinner, they even look healthier. Well, you're saying, well, that's a poor country, but
no, Mexico's last on my list. I've spent a lot of time in Mexico. That is not one of my preferred locations for bugging out. I'd prefer like Ecuador, or Costa Rica, maybe, or Panama if I had to go south.
I would love to. I would love to move to Ecuador, man. But I don't think the wife would be too happy if we were over there. But anyways.
Okay. So yeah, man. Well, anyways, Anthony, thanks for being on the show. I just want to do a really quick video update for people. You know, generally the feeling here is on the ground is just one of being squeezed. It's like squeezing blood out of a turnip. The sheeple. They have no idea what's going on. They're just running around like chickens with their head cut off. They have no idea that this is a planned stage event to just squeeze.
So you know what, George? I've noticed that the sheep are starting to complain a little bit, though. That when you're getting when they're taking your life force away, I think anybody can notice that.
Yeah. Well, I for one am gonna make a renewed commitment to spend more time at the beach. Go camping in the mountains and have more time. Well, I've spent way too much time with my kids this summer, literally 24/7. I need some time for myself. And hopefully you can come along on some of these bug outs and where we can just enjoy our life before the New World Order clamps down. What do you think?
No choice, man. Mental health is really important. I was getting to the point I don't have a choice. I need a bug out.
Thanks, brother. Take care.
All